Hey everyone, it is Thursday, March 2nd. The time's around 12:22 p.m. and the temperature is 4 degrees Celsius. And I'm here at a spot known as the Polson Pier. And there is Rebel, a large nightclub. And just beyond that is the Cabana Pool Bar, a rather popular spot in the summer. And a look over at the Toronto Islands. And of course, part of the downtown skyline. And it's interesting how a lot of the big towers in the financial district have been blocked over the years by smaller condos built just to the south. Still looks rather impressive. And for this one, I'll be hopping on the e-bike over there and going for a ride over to Cherry Street, which is undergoing a massive reconfiguration, and then I'll be heading south down to the Waterfront Trail, and then I think I'll go west, maybe as far as Strachan, and then I'll start making my way back up north. I haven't really thought this one through very much. I just wanted to get down here and see this view in the wintertime and go for a ride, so it seemed like a good enough excuse. So, all right, let's get moving here. I thought it would be easier to walk my bike through that slop. And there used to be a large drive-in out this way. And a go-kart track. The whole area was known as the Docks Entertainment Complex. And this is a mostly former, but still kind of industrial area that's being completely redeveloped into an area known as Villiers Island, which you can see straight ahead. And they're planning a massive new community here. And there'll even be a streetcar or LRT connection. All right, so this is Cherry Street I'm approaching. Got this bike lane installed. I'm just gonna hop off for a sec. There, we'll take a look at the skyline view from this side of the bridge. This is one of four bridges that have been shipped in from Halifax. And I think this view is a little better than the one where I started from. my gloves back on. You can see two new bridges straight ahead. One of them is configured for transit. And this part, as a cyclist, can be confusing because where am I supposed to go? There's a solid curb there, but also a right turn sign in the bike lane. And making my way up, I saw a couple of cyclists, or at least one guy, going the wrong way on that side. I figure they thought that was the best route, and it probably was. See another bridge straight ahead that's been installed. So that not a bike lane on my right, that's a sidewalk. But the bike lane on the left side here has become a two-way again. No one behind me. So those two bridges straight ahead will one day be part of Cherry Street. Area that I'm on now will be decommissioned. It says cyclist detour go right, but I don't want to go in that direction. The waterfront trail to the right, which is to the east of here, is out of commission from here till about Carlaw. So unfortunately there isn't a continuous waterfront trail anymore, at least not, I think, for the next few years. Interesting place to be taking your baby for a stroll. So this is heading west, and just on the right is Lakeshore Boulevard and the Gardner Expressway on top of it. And that building straight ahead on the right is actually a timber construction building. And there'll be another one coming up. And the street on the right is Queens Quay East. Imagine there won't be too many people down near the waterfront today, given that it is a weekday and it's the middle of winter. There's a neat boardwalk just over on the left that runs alongside the lake. And we'll lead you to Sugar Beach. Which is straight ahead. That's the Redpath Sugar Refinery on the right, where Sugar Beach takes its name from. I'll go take a close look at the waterfront maybe when I get to HTO Park. Of Jarvis Street just on the right. And the smell of sugar is in the air. is Yonge Street. The very foot of what some call the longest street in the world. And yes, I checked behind me to make sure no cyclists were coming. She just tried to cross against the signal and a car had to come to a stop. And now I'm on the west side of downtown. And this is the foot of Bay Street, and on the left is Harbor Square Park. That's where you'll find the Toronto Island Ferry, or at least the ferry terminal. I was down in this area yesterday doing a live stream. Although that was of the walking variety. There goes a 509 Harborfront streetcar. On the left is the Harborfront Center. And this is the foot of Reese Street. And here is HTO Park. Another artificial beach, similar to Sugar Beach. There's some Canadian geese. A good spot to watch a lot of planes taking off and landing at the island airport. There goes a Porter jet. I guess jet wouldn't be the right word, as jets are not permitted to fly out of the island airport. And that is the Sky Dome straight ahead. I think a lot of people are excited to see what that'll be like this year after the first round of renovations is complete. The streetcar. This is a training car. All right, are we playing chicken here? How about you walk on the other side? This is the foot of Spadina Avenue. Was a complimentary shuttle that'll take you from Billy Bishop Airport to just across the street from Union Station. I'm not sure how that works, if just anyone can take it, or at least one person in your party has to have boarded a flight or work at the airport. And this is Bathurst Street on the right, and just to the left is the Island Airport. There goes another plane taking off. And it's into Coronation Park. I used to play softball at these fields. I don't know if that league ever resumed after the pandemic. Straight ahead are the Prince's Gates. You often hear people say Princess Gates. That marks the eastern entrance to Exhibition Place. It's going to be quite a long light cycle to wait for at times. is the foot of Strachan Avenue. So I'm going to start making my way north. What a long light cycle. I pressed the button when I got here. I've been here in the summertime where there's just dozens of cyclists piled up waiting in this spot for the light. So if you're wondering if it's a winter thing, just because there's a lower volume of people out on bikes and walking, the answer is no. This is just the way the intersection is set up. There's a guy waiting to cross on the other side who seems a little impatient. There's no way I'm not getting the signal now. We got a walk sign on the other side. There's a sign there that says pedestrians cross at west side. So this is strictly a bicycle crossing that seems to have absolutely no priority whatsoever. And I did press the button right when I got here too. There we go. They're like, all right. Little man on his bike, you can go. So now it is north up Strachan Avenue. And this would be Fleet Street. Bentway, a public space that runs underneath the Gardiner Expressway. And on the left is the Liberty Village neighborhood. Ooh. I'm gonna go left here at Douro Street. And that'll take us through part of Liberty Village. Strachan Avenue here terminates to the north at Trinity Bellwoods Park. Let's see if I get an advanced screen. No. And this is Shaw Street. So I guess I'll just take Shaw Street north here, as it's got a bike lane for the most part. Although, oddly, there's no bike lanes for this next stretch. On the left is the Cam Beach. That's a large mental health facility. And it used to be a psychiatric hospital on that lot a long time ago. And this is Queen Street West. And once I get north of Dundas Street, which is also just north of Trinity Bellwoods Park, the bike lane will appear, well, the dedicated bike lane. And this is the street where surveyors found there was more bike use than vehicles using it. although I don't know if that holds up throughout the winter. I'm guessing it doesn't. Here's Dundas Street West straight ahead. And into the cozy confines of the bike lane, which were installed back in 2013. Wow, these cars are going a little wider than usual, because on-street parking in wintertime can make it difficult to get right up to the curb, and then you've got that layer of snow and muck to contend with. This is also the street where the police decided to hang out and bust cyclists for rolling through stop signs slowly, a practice they've been seen doing themselves, or been seen doing themselves. And there was a bit of an uproar over that. Is that really an effective use of their limited resources? And we're at College Street. This is Little Italy. I think even for doing that, you'd have been nailed with a ticket. And we're up to Harvard Street. Which also has a bike lane. That is the street where the rear wheel my other e-bike got a flat. That was a video that was actually published for this morning. And this is Bloor Street, so do I continue on Shaw or do I take Bloor? Well, what I'm gonna do is check the battery life on my camera, which I think might be on the low side right now. Yeah, I'm gonna swap cameras. We'll be back in a second. And we're back, and I'm not sure if this camera has much more battery life. Oh well. So do I want to go straight on Shaw? I think that's enough of Shaw. Let's go right here. At Bloor. So this is east along Bloor Street West. And just on the left is Christy Pitts Park. Of this thing. And just on the left is Crispy Station. And it is through Koreatown. And this is Bathurst Street. And straight ahead is the Annex neighborhood. There's a lot of good food options in this neighborhood. And this is Brunswick Avenue. And this is the point where my toes start to feel frozen. I was getting away with my running shoes and a couple of pairs of socks. And I guess my toes just hit their breaking point and now they're telling me to stop doing whatever I'm doing. Alright, here is Spadina coming up. And much of the area. On my right is part of the University of Toronto St. George campus. Bedford Road. Bike lane comes to an abrupt temporary end there. This car is turning right. That car was parking, but it stuck its nose right into the bike lane. Get ready. hit me if I were decided at the time. Bay Street. So I think I'll end this one when I get to Yonge Bloor, or maybe just north of there. Here's Yonge Bloor. I think I found out why my right foot is frozen. Somehow my shoe got soaking wet. That's not good. Anyways, on that note, I hope you enjoyed this one. Starting down in the Portlands. Riding along the waterfront over to Strachan, and then connecting to Shaw, up to Bloor, and over to here at Yonge Bloor. Let me know your thoughts and comments down below, and if you wish to support the channel, there's links to my Patreon and YouTube channel membership in the description. I have an Instagram account at Johnny Strides, and there is a super thanks button here below the videos if you wish to say thanks that way. Anywho, thank you for watching. Stay warm, stay safe. And I will catch you on the next one.